When you leave the on-deck circle and go to the batter's box, it should be a walk of confidence. Just like your feet and your weight, the lower part of the body is the physical foundation for hitting. Confidence is the mental foundation for hitting. It's actually the mental foundation for base running and fielding and pitching and every other part of the game. And we've got to have hitters that develop confidence. One of the big problems in hitting in fast pitch softball, might be the biggest problem actually, is the lack of confidence. And actually some of our advanced camps that we have for players in the summer, we might spend an hour or two on how to develop confidence, how to regain confidence when you're struggling. And there are some drills, there are some techniques for developing confidence. You want to walk from the on-deck circle to home plate with confidence, and you want to maintain that confidence, of course, once you get up there. Let's look at some specific ways that we can develop confidence, some things we can practice, some techniques, some thoughts about developing confidence so that we can have it when we get to home plate and we can maintain it again while we struggle, because sometimes you got the confidence and then you lose it. One of the best ways that I know is to use the past. Now, I know you're often told forget the past and dwell in the present. Well, I want us to use both the past and the future so that the present moment, the kairos, is better. Not forget the past, not go out into the future, but use both of them so that we have a better present. In the past, you've got some good things that happen and you've got some bad things that happen. Unfortunately, the hitter often is worrying about and remembering the strikeouts and the pop-ups and the weak ground balls. Remember the hard hit ball 2 weeks ago off this same pitcher? Remember the six in a row you busted yesterday in the inter-squad game or off the pitching machine or whatever? Remember the good things from the past. Pull them forward to the moment that you're in right now. And then visualize, imagine. All right, that's all visualization is. It's a mental skill of imagination, of pretending the same thing the player did when she was a four-year-old girl playing with dolls in her room or whatever game she was playing. It's imagination, it's pretending. Visualize what you want to occur in the future rather than having a fear of what might occur. Too often the hitter's fearing the strikeout again, the pop-up, the messing up, the failing. Visualize and project yourself succeeding in the future. And the future's only a second or two away maybe. So take the best of the past and pull it forward to the present. Take the best that you can imagine in the future and pull it back from the future to the now. And put these together so that the now can be better, so that you can achieve more. So use the past, use the good past, use the positive memories that you had and the visualizing of the positive imagination of the future and bring them all together into that kairos moment in the batter's box. That helps to build confidence. A drill that you can use with players is to have them sit down and write on a piece of paper the good things that they've done. Too often they write the bad things they've done mentally across their brain. On a piece of paper, write the good things that have happened in their future. The hit they got 2 weeks ago again that won the ball game. Those moments they can remember. Or have a brag party. Have players partner up and tell each other good things about themselves. Hey, I really like the way you stand at the plate. I like the way you attack the ball. I like the way that you hit the drop. I have problems with that, but you hit the drop really well. Or you stay back on the changeup. I like the fact that you can hit well with two strikes. I like the fact that you're aggressive, that you're smart. Whatever those things may be that are the pluses of a player, they can sit down and have a brag party with each other. They need to positive flood each other with positive comments about each other so that they can build up their confidence. They need to learn to hang around people who increase their confidence. Maybe that's why children like grandparents so much. Grandparents make you feel good about yourself. And it's okay to feel good about yourself as a hitter. So you want to hang around some players, maybe on that dugout bench again, players who will build up your confidence before you get up to the plate. Write down things that you did in practice. And that's a good habit. After practice, write down two or three things each day that you did well. Just like having goals for practice, going into practice, when you write down or tell others things you want to accomplish today, well, after the practice or the game, write down the things that you did well today, kind of keeping a diary. Be thankful for things. Look around you and ask yourself what you can be thankful for. But build up that confidence. It's so critical to being a good hitter. And use your imagination and find other ways to increase confidence. We could spend a lot of time, perhaps an entire videotape, on increasing confidence. But those are some tips to help the player develop confidence, to walk to the plate with confidence, and to regain that confidence, which we'll go into more a little bit later.